Well, on the subject of style, you know, the right outfit can make a person feel confident about the way they look. But to really take up your wardrobe a notch, dressing in colors that are complementary can also create that wow factor.
And here to tell us more about how to choose colors that communicate the right visual message is the author of the book, Reinventing Your Style, 7 Strategies for Looking Powerful, Dynamic, and Inspiring, fashion stylist Jennifer Butler. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I must say you look powerful, dynamic, inspiring.
Yeah, you are looking awfully good in that blue color.
I realize I'm matching my book.
Yes, you are. Look at that. Very good.
And the inside cover is my shade of red.
Ah.
So when you're developing your business card or your website,
wow, look at that.
You enhance your personal colors.
People are so hesitant to wear bold colors.
Yes.
We're a neutral society. What would you say just about the need to wear colors and color strategy in your wardrobe?
Well, in terms of wearing color, most people do dress neutrally, but we don't drive a car in neutral gear, right? So if you're really trying to drive powerfully in your life, you want to be enhanced by color. So color defines your personality, and it also defines the psychology of color, allows you to dress your intention. You know, a lot of us have powerful messages that we want to convey. So today, I'm conveying the power of my message by wearing my power color. This is my color palette.
Ah.
So let's look at it for a minute.
Beautiful
hold
colors.
That up for
this
you.
Is not
right?
The five primaries.
So, right? So one of the colors
that
is really important is the color of intimacy, and that's the skin tone. When I receive
that
color.
Not that kind of intimacy guy.
It's not this kind of show, Jennifer.
When I receive my color, which is my skin tone, and you can see it softens me right away.
Ah.
This is the first date color guy for the guys.
When really?
Your skin tone, we talked about it, could be kind of a flesh tone, maybe on the ruddy side.
To go with that spicier lavender aroma.
Right,
uh-huh.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah.
So the skin tone creates a sense of relatedness, which is really important. Like on a first job interview, on a first date, family outings, this would be a color I could use to paint my bedroom or family room.
So you want a color that kind of matches your skin tone.
So
yes.
What does my color say about me? Black, like my heart?
Well, Black, you're wearing neutral today.
I did it on purpose because I knew you'd be here talking about colors.
But I want to give you a key to another one.
Oh,
right?
Okay.
Let's talk for a minute about his eyes. Now look into her eyes for a minute. What
guy
color?
Guy has nice eyes.
What color would you say his eyes are?
They're kind of a hazel green.
Yeah.
Huh?
They
and they probably change
all
with what
the
you're
time.
Wearing.
Right.
Yeah.
So when you wear green, the green is what we call the centering color. And for us, when we wear it, it's our power of negotiation. So have you ever wanted to negotiate anything in your life, a contract, a raise, negotiate anything with your girlfriend, anything in your life?
So you wear your eye color?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Your eye color.
Watch out when I'm wearing green.
And it's actually the lights of your eyes. So although my eyes look brown, the lights of them are actually gold. So we're learning a whole other arena about color and its significance, because over 50% of us is visual communication.
Mm-hmm.
So unless I'm aligned with my own coloring, then who am I impersonating? What if I'm wearing your color? Then I give out mixed messages.
Now, we were talking before the show that the colors that you like may not be the best color choices for you.
Yes, that is a very important statement. So let's look at that for a minute, because oftentimes you and I are attracted to our opposite. Right? We have that in our friendships. We have that in our marriages.
Definitely. Definitely.
Right?
Yeah.
So if I, on a subconscious level, am going out shopping and I pick the opposite of who I am, then I'm not dressed as myself. So when I looked at my wardrobe in 1979, when I had my colors done, I looked at my wardrobe. I had a lot of pink. Pink is my mother's color. I had a lot of taupe. That's my brother's hair color. I had a lot of kind of that beautiful seafoam foam green. That's another brother's hair color. And I had a lot of a really cool burgundy, which was my dad's color. So there I was, trying to be everybody else in my family instead of myself.
Except if you, yourself. Now, you brought some boards here.
Oh, I did. So I thought we'd have fun. We want to guess essence, all right? So Mother Nature is the master colorist, and she's the one that invents our life, basically. And she, in the four seasons, gives us an essence. It's like a life force. So when we dress that life force, that's our full power.
Okay.
So this is what we call the sunlight, and I thought we'd just kind of hold them up to him and look at her and see if you can kind of guess. You have to lean it a little bit toward the camera so it doesn't glare as much.
So we're guessing.
So this is sunlight.
Okay.
All right. Okay. All right. So let's
set
that down. Upside down.
This one is upside down.
You want me to hold something?
So this is now going to be twilight.
Oh, that's pretty.
You can tell we're good with visual aids.
All right.
Although Guy can't see him, are you?
This next one is the firelight.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Firelight, see all the warm tones.
What is good for you change?
Yes. As we grow and change, like I now have white hair. My hair used to be dark brown, right? So my color palette changes. We redo the colors every 2.5 to 5 years.
Oh, really?
Okay. Depending on your life changes.
And finally.
And this is the moonlight.
Oh.
Okay.
All right. So this gives us the person's their inner radiance. And then because I have 4,000 colors, can you imagine that inventory? 4,000 colors, I'm giving you your personal portrait, your personal DNA of coloring, which is the color chart.
I love that.
Isn't that
beautiful?
Great?
And you have a beautiful book, Reinventing Your Style, Seven Strategies for Looking Dynamic, Powerful, and Inspiring. And a lot of the people that you portray, you show how what colors work for them and how they work. And it really is a beautiful way of explaining.
And this would be, and you said this would be a great way to design your business card or maybe even
your website
to make it more attractive to people. They
want
to go there and check you out.
So what we did is, again, we're mirroring Mother Nature. There's over 90 photographs in there. So we have a picture of, say we're going to discuss the amount of design you can wear. So we have a picture of very simple design, like a smooth lake. Then we have a picture of like very smooth pillars, and then someone with smooth hair and smooth skin. And they realize, oh, okay, I should be wearing smooth because that's what works for me.
Wow, okay, well, pick up the book. You gotta check it out.
Check out
Lots of great tips and ideas.
Dot
Jennifer
com.
Butler, yeah.
Thank you so much
Thank
for being
you.
Here.
Thank you,
go out
very
and get
much.
A new wardrobe.
I know.
Yes.
yeah, we'll work on
we'll
that,
work
Felicia.
On it.